In this presentation, I am not going to show some advances on research or technological developments concerning solar cooking. The idea of these presentations is to show a possibility to spread the concept of solar cooking. We are very lucky to live today, because today the sun is a very friendly star. This will not occur in the next 4 million years, when the Sun will be converted in a giant red star and will enlarge until the Earth, and the Earth will be completely roasted. So what to do is to enjoy it. And then a way to enjoy the Sun is practicing the solar cooking. So what I propose is quite a solar cooking tourism. But before, I would like tell about the history of the tourism and how the solar cooking can be included in this pattern of historical pattern of the tourism. First of all, the tourism was only for the higher classes. It's a part of the education, and the young boys and girls will travel along the some places to learn about the some culture, like in Italy, Egypt, and so. After, in this case, we have the tourism for educational purposes. During the industrialization, the more people can go to have tourism, and so we assist to the massification of tourism that in many times had damaged some tourism destinations. Against this massification, it appears the sustainable tourism. So the tourism is concerned about its footprint, and this footprint has to be as lower as possible. As an extension of this sustainable tourism, it appeared the creative tourism. So the tourists are not only interested to see the places and to see the monuments, and so they are interested to learn more about the communities they are visiting, and a way to do this is the creative tourism, to make some tasks that are from the people, from local people. And in this case, I think that solar cooking and the making workshops of the construction of solar oven will be included in this case of the creative tourism. More recently, the target was not only to have a footprint as lower as possible, but also to have a positive footprint of the tourism. So tourists go to a place, and when they are in these places, they are just doing well to this place with a positive footprint. So when doing this solar cooking tourism, we have to spread some messages. The first one is that it results. The second one is very easy to do it. It is possible to have it at home, and the oven are cheap and easy to build. And also, you can prepare very yummy meals. We have two ways of introducing this solar cooking tourism. One of them is another hard way, promoting workshops, constructing solar ovens with tasting food. Another way is a soft way, is including the solar cooking as tasting food inside other packages. Concerning the hard approach, we have to very careful on the planning activities. First of all, we have to make before the arrival of the tourists the food preparation and starting the solar cooking, because this is a very time consuming and this time can bore the tourists. When the tourists arrival, after we can do a brief explanation about solar cooking, we open solar oven, measuring the temperature of the pots. This is very important as a target to demonstrate efficiency of solar cooking. And after, we have this tasting the solar food with the beverage. After this, we have workshop on solar urban construction, and finally, we have a lottery to raffle the built solar cooking over the tourists. What about concerns and materials used in this approach? First of all, we have to know very well the movement, the apparent movement of the sun and resulting shadows, not to compromise the solar cooking. After, we have to have a digital thermometer and a cartoon already marked with cuts and folds to construct the solar oven, empty snack packs, double-sided zip tabs. So we have here some part of material that we need in this activity. We have the thermometer. We can do a very simple experience using a white plate, black plate, and black plate with a greenhouse to see the increase of the temperature over these situations. And for the construction, I propose a DINAS, our panel cooker, because it's very easy to construct. And in these those dimensions using A1, and in my case, in 41 degrees of latitude, and with the sky with some small high clouds, we can get easily 108-110 degrees Celsius as temperature. So it's very easy to do, and the tourists will not very bored on constructing those things. As you see, we have the cartoon with the folds and cuts marked, the adhesive tabs, and the packs, snack packs to make the reflection superfaces. So, in a soft way, we put the solar cooking inside a touristical package. So the preparation has to be done before the arrival of tourists. Tourists arrive, so we have a brief explanation about solar cooking, and after we have the opening of the solar cooking, measuring the pot's temperature. We have the tasting the solar food with beverage, and after we propose an observation of the sky. If you are in a place with a dark sky, this is very interesting, this marriage between solar cooking and star observation, because every time is a good time to see stars, is also a good time to perform the solar cooking. And as a curiosity, I can show you this meeting is doing at the same time in Spain and India. We can see how is the sky in Spain and India at that time when we look to the north. So after those activities, we have to conclude that sun is the most democratic renewable energy, because in fact is not practical and easy to have inside a flat, a dam, a wind turbine, an ocean with waves, a connection to a volcano. But concerning the solar thermic energy, yes, we can. Yes, you can do it. Just to conclude, I would like to show a final reflection that I heard 7 years ago in a street of São Paulo in Brazil. It's about sun, because sun, when it rises, it is for everyone, but shadow is only for someone. Thank you for your attention.